Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are fine. Students, today we are going to do the exercises of lesson number 6 of your English 2 book. So I would request you all to please take out page number 57 in your English 2 book. Now, students, in this chapter, on this page, you will see the communication section, which is given on page 57. In this lesson, we see Ramchand express his gratitude towards Premchand for giving his money. We all know that we must use the golden words, sorry, please, excuse me, thank you, to express what we feel. However, many times we forget to do that. So students, in this exercise, which is given on page number 58, you have to turn the page, exercise A. Write how and which golden words would you use in the following situations. So in this exercise, you will read the sentence. You have to read the sentence which is given here. You are at the airport and have a flight to catch. However, there is a group of people walking right in front of you. So in this, you have to write the golden word such as sorry, please, excuse me. So which golden word which you use if you have this condition, alright? So you are at the airport and have a flight to catch. However, there's a group of people walking right in front of you. So what will you say to those people who are walking in front of you? You'll say, excuse me, can you please get aside, right? This is what you are going to say to the people who are moving ahead of you, right? Because you're getting late. So the golden word you will use here is excuse me. So you'll write, excuse me, can you please get aside, okay? Now the second one, you are working in a group on a peace day project. You realize you are out of glue for the model and some other group members have spare bottles of glue. So what will you do? You will ask for the glue bottles with those students, right? So what would you say to them? You'll say, please, may I take a bottle of glue? Please, right? This is what you're going to ask. May I please take the bottle of glue? Right? So you'll write, may I please take the, may I please get the bottle of glue, or may I please take the bottle of glue? Alright. Now, grammar section. Singular and plural. You have learned about it in the previous class as well. And you know what are singular and plural nouns, right? The plurals of nouns are formed in different ways by adding S, ES, IES, VES to a singular noun. So students, we change the noun from singular to plural by adding S, ES, IES or VES, correct? Some nouns form plurals by changing the vowel in the singular number. Man, if you have to change the man to plural, then we'll write men. Woman, then women, right? So this is how we change the words from singular to plural. Some nouns form plurals by adding en to the singular. Whereas in some of the nouns, we have to add en to change it from singular to plural. For example, ox is singular and oxen is plural. Child is singular and children is plural, right? Now some nouns are the same in singular and plural form. Sheep, deer, dozen, people, they will always remain same. Either it is singular or plural. Some nouns sound plural though they are actually singular. For example, news and mathematics. There is S at the end of the word, news and mathematics, but they are actually singular. So they'll sound like plural, but they are actually singular. Now on page number 59, there is an exercise given, exercise A. Correct the following sentences. Students, you must know that for singular, if there is a singular word, we add is, right? And for plural, we use are, right? So in the first one, you can see, number one, signs are my favorite subject. So science is just one, right? Science is singular. So are we going to use are or is for science? We'll write science is my favorite subject. So the sentence will remain same. It's just that are will change into is because science is singular. Number two, humans is more intelligent than animals. So humans, as you can say, it's plural. So for plural nouns, we will use are. So what are we going to write here? Humans are more intelligent than animals. So is will change into are. Humans are more intelligent than animals. Number three. Where is these people going early in the morning? So people is what? Plural, right? These, because these means there are so many people, right? It is plural. So is will change into are. Where are these people going early in the morning? So full sentence will remain same. It's just that is will change into are. You have to correct it. You have to write are in place of is. Where are these people going early in the morning? Number four. I bought 100 apple for my classmate to eat. So there are so many classmates, right? And he bought 100 apple. So 100 apple means there are so many apples, the plural apple. So what will we do? We have to write apples. We will write S after apple. So I bought 100 apples for my classmates to eat. Number five, the oxen was plowing the field. So oxen is the plural of ox. So how many ox plow the field? One ox is enough to plow the field, right? So we will write the ox was plowing the field. Okay? I hope you've done it. Now in exercise B, you have to change the sentences from singular to plural. Number one, an old lady came walking by with a bag on her back. So you have to change the singular ones into plurals. For example, the old ladies, the lady will change into ladies, came walking by with a bag will change into plural again, bags on their backs. So students, exercise B is your homework. You have to do it in your book itself, okay? I'll repeat, exercise B is your homework. Page number 59, exercise B is your homework. You have to do it in your book itself. What you all have to do is, you have to just change the words into plural. The singular words you have to change into plural. For example, in the second one, cat is singular. You have to write cats and got $200 for it. So, you have to write, he again sold the cats and got $200 for it. It's very simple. You just have to change the words which are singular into plural. I hope you'll do it. Okay? And the rest of the exercises we'll do in our next class. Students, take care. Bye-bye.